How's doing, guys? It's hooky up. Well, my shoulder is almost healed, right? There's still it's still a bit like a rusty hinge, but in general I've got fair movement. I've also had both my vaccinations. I had my second vaccination on the 16th of June, right? So as far as I'm aware, that's me. That's me, right? I'm done, right? Even though I'm not allowed to drink inside a pub in Ireland at the moment. But I booked a holiday. I like Tai Chi. Tai Chi is my thing, right? I'm technically a Tai Chi instructor, but I was supposed to start a class last year. That was when the plan was to do it. Ain't fucking happening, right? And it probably won't happen this year. And to be honest, because even when classes were open last year, partner work was heavily restricted, which is where the martial art comes in. I'd be looking to train for another maybe year to get my fucking salt back, you know, to get myself comfortable enough to teach other people how to block and things like that. So I'm considering leaving it till I'm 50. I'm actually 48 now. I was 48 this year. So 50 seems a grand year to start, you know. But last 2019, I was at a push hands competition. I got a bronze medal. I'll be honest, I get fucking thrown about like a rag doll in one of the fights. I'm not gonna lie to you, but in the points, which is the basically once you move you're fucked thing, I got bronze, so that they can't take that away from me. I'm going to a 3-day push hands workshop in the Czech Republic in September. The format is going to be workshops in the morning, then go for your lunch, then come back, and then it's one-on-one push hands to whatever level you and your opponent decides, right? So if your opponent goes, don't do this, then you don't do that, right? You fucking, there's a gentlemanly agreement. But if you say fuck it to the death, then it's to the death, right? Facetious as it is, not what I was making the video for, right? Because what I'm actually doing at the moment is I'm ramping up my practice to get to that stage. I'm ramping up my exercising every day. I exercise every day. And at the end of it, I meditate, right? I do some sitting meditation for the 10 minutes, right? And what I've started doing is there's this book, and this is it here, 365 Tao by Dunring Dao, right? And every day, now I've had this book for a while, but every day it gives you a thing to read, right? And what I'll do is I'll read the day's page and then I'll do my sit meditation, right? And it's really, really nice. I'll actually just read today's, right? I apologize if it takes too long, then I apologize for that, right? But this is today's one. It's flow, right? It's just an example, but you read it, then you sit and you mull it over. It was great. The first one I got when I started doing this was meditation. Yeah. And then the next two were actually, the next three, I guess, two. The next two were pertaining to martial arts, which is really quite nice. Okay. 182, flow. If the boulders are moved, even a river will change its flow. Except for the occasional flooding, the mighty river keeps to its bed. It flows where it finds openings between the cliffs and rocks. If the river is dammed, if the cliff walls are moved, if the boulders are shifted, it will flow a different course. It could even be made to flow backwards if the earth moved far enough. So it is with the flow of our lives. Once the fixed objects of our lives shift, the circumstances change. If we move to another city, life will change. If we marry one person over another, life will be different. If we situate our business in a good neighbourhood, life will be prosperous. If we choose a house in a good setting, life will be healthy. If we arrange our furniture properly, life will be comfortable. If we eat correctly, life will be prolonged. In short, followers of the Tao realized that the flow of life can be affected and to some degree consciously manipulated simply by altering the parameters. Life is the flow of energy. It is the air we breathe, the force that moves the weather, the force of all minds combined. It keeps the river flowing, our hearts beating, and the skies blue. The flow of energy moves constantly according to the fixed points that exist at any given moment. Therefore, by manipulating the cardinal points of our lives, we can change the flow. The freedom to choose and to change belongs to us. I'll read that tonight again, and then I'll contemplate it. Right now, I'm only doing 10 minutes, to be fair, because I see more benefit for the exercise that the low impact muscle exercises that I do. But yeah, it's been really nice. Like there's been different ones. Like one was about force, but using minimal force. Another one about axle was based on the rotation and how your body rotates. There was another one on breathing, right? Things like that. And you can sit and mull it over. And it's not airy fairy woo stuff, you know? It's not like the tea, right? It doesn't fucking say any of that shit, right? Which is nice, right? In fact, it's one of the words that I don't think my instructor or me ever really uses is the word chi, right? It's a commonly misused concept, right? And it belongs to the Chinese who know what it means, or the fucking people with dream catchers. But yeah, so I'm gonna do a bit of so I guess it's called a bit of a version of soft judo, I guess. Push hands. Gentleman's judo, I guess, right? Because throws tend only to be done in competition when there's mats or when there's been an agreement to do so. But for 3 days, I'm going to go to another country with people I've never met and enjoy it. Yeah, and I was hoping to build on I was hoping to build on my competition in 2019. Excuse me. I was actually at a competition in Spain 2019, then a master class in Italy in 2019, and the hope was to build on that and go to different countries around the world and fucking train with as many people as I can. That's what it's all about, right? So apparently this group, they do another workshop in Scotland, the Tai Chi Union of Great Britain, and another one in Hanover where there's a competition element. And if that happens, the plan is I'll be going to that next year. But that's yeah. Till next time, guys. This is Huck. Peace out.